Eternal gracious Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for this opportunity. Lord, we thank you we're able to come into your house of worship and fellowship, Lord, this day. Now, Lord, I pray right now that you may remove every distraction, every hindrance, every obstacle that will prevent us from worshiping you, that will prevent us from hearing your word as well as receiving your word. So, God, on this back to school Sunday, God, I pray right now, God, that your word may go forth, God, and touch every youth as well as every adult here, God, that would help us, God, to reach our full level within Jesus Christ. Lord, I pray right now for articulation of speech and clarity of mind to preach the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. It's in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ that we pray. Every cross, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Coming from Proverbs, Book of Wisdom, 15. Looking at this one verse, verse 14. Proverbs 15, verse 14. On this, I like to call it back to school last Sunday, education Sunday, because no matter where we are, we all need more education. Am I right there, little one? We there. Amen. Proverbs 15, verse 14 reads this verse in the New King James Version. The heart of him who has understanding seeks knowledge, but the mouth of fools feeds on foolishness. And let's read that one again. The heart of him who has understanding seeks knowledge, but the mouth of fools feeds on foolishness. I believe another translation, today's English version makes it real blunt and plain. It says, intelligent people seek knowledge, but stupid people are satisfied with ignorance. That's another translation. Intelligent people seek knowledge, but stupid people deal with ignorance. But just a few moments of your thoughts and prayers. I want to put a tag on this text and preach from the topic. Knowledge is fruitfulness. Knowledge is fruitfulness. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Knowledge
is fruitfulness.
Fruitfulness.
Find another neighbor. Say, knowledge.
Knowledge
is fruitfulness.
Is fruitfulness.
Amen. Amen. We live in a time whereby education is not taken serious by many people. Many people go to school day by day, simply go through the motions, but have no idea and no concept on the importance of a quality education. Can you just look back over your life when you were in school and find out how many people in your classmates sitting to the left and to the right of you did not place enough value on education? They will come to school ill-prepared, they will come to school acting like a fool and not really going for a true education. And because they're not educated, they're in a bad situation right now. I'm here to let you know that education is fruitful. Education will open up doors. Education will make a way for you. However, we are in a society now whereby we're so caught up on technology. We're caught up on having the latest BlackBerry, the latest iPhone, iPad, iTablet. We're so caught up with the internet. We're so caught up with science and technology, which is good, but no one really ever pushes reading. No one ever really pushes English. No one ever pushes common sense training. No one ever really pushes critical thinking. Can you imagine that for a second? We're so caught up on math and science. We know how to text everybody with TTYL and AOL. I mean, LOL and AWOL. We know all the cliches, Chris, but many of our kids and people today don't have a clue on how to read nor how to write. Do you know people like that? They know all of the technology, but they have no clue on how to read the newspaper. They have no clue on how to connect the dots. They're so busy, caught up on technology, that they have no idea what's happening in their community or foreign affairs. You're not feeling like I need you to. Just think about many church people that you know right now. Yes, they're Bible oriented. They know Genesis to Revelation, but have no clue what's happening in the White House. They have no clue what's happening with healthcare. They have no clue what's happening with this social injustice, which is a justice to most folks, but injustice to people, brown and black people all over the world. We got too many people in this world, Jay, that refuse to become educated, that refuse to have knowledge. And whenever you become miseducated, you will do what Carter G. Woodson said, you will go to the back door when someone sent you, and if there's not one there, you will cut one out for yourself rather than opening your own back door. Let me help illustrate this for you. I was out of town over the weekend, and while watching TV during my time of rest and eat, I saw on the television they had commercials for ITT Technology. The Institute of Technology is showing how many people who went through high school decided they didn't go to college but made up their mind that they were going to some trade school, a technology school, to go ahead and further their education. It helped me out because it showed that these people decide not to sit down, not to waste their time doing nothing, but rather to go to school and make a difference in their life. Can we be honest for a second? Many people in our life have told themselves that they're too old to go back to school. They don't have enough money to go back to school. And my question is, what's stopping you? Why are you using excuses to not get an education? Why are you using excuses to remain stuck or stupid? And can we be honest for a second? Say, we know a whole lot of people that are stuck on being stupid. My fault, you didn't like that terminology. They're stuck on being content in the position that they're in right now. Why? Because it's too hard, because it takes too much time, it's too much energy. Well, I'm here to let you know, if you're part of God's family, why not go back to school? Why not pick up a newspaper and read? Why not pick up a book and open it and expand yourself? Because education means you have opportunities to do certain things, but we have a whole lot of people, they like to get stuck in their neighborhood. Yes, we're in Prince George's County, where we got a whole lot of people never left Prince George's County, or if you crossing the street to D.C., you're living in Southeast, you ain't never left Southeast. You've been in Northwest, never left Northwest. Isn't that a shame that too many people like to get stuck in a box? And whenever you're stuck in the box, you will always find somebody who is depressed, who is sad, and who is complaining. But on this day, I'm here to let you know that knowledge is fruitful. What do you mean, Pastor Bob? Knowledge is fruitful. If you want to be all that God has called you to be, you're going to open up a book and you're going to expand your intellect. You're going to do more than just read the Bible. You're going to read the newspaper. You're not feeling like I need you to. My dad is in the house today, and I remember back in the day growing up, he can testify. This is no lie, but this is a straight testimony. When he was in bed reading the newspaper and I was just chilling, he will always say, when are you going to read the newspaper? You got to do something more than play the arcade game. You got to do something more than read the sports section. Am I telling a lie? He is actually nodding his head and said, that's right. He said, you got to read the paper every day. Why? Because how can I be educated if I'm blind to what's happening in the world today? Please help me understand, my friends, that a person who has a heart of God wants to learn anything and everything, because God has not called us to be dumb or stupid, but rather God has called us to be intelligent and to be smart and use common sense. The information is there, but what are we going to do with it? And that's why it shouts me with the proverb that they say, the heart of him who has understanding seeks knowledge. Well, what do you mean by the heart of him? The one who's after God's own heart. If you love God, you want to do everything that God has for you. We talk about it all the time, that God is supreme, that God is all-knowing. Why not know what God knows? Okay, let me help you out. Valerie's in the house. The baker's in the house. Valerie always say, I love God because God brings forth nature. Look at the trees. Look at the greenery. Look at nature. Look at the birds, the swans, the ducks, everything that's happening. Well, guess what? That's nature. And if God created nature, why can't we who want to be like God understand why the swans go and fly in a certain direction? How is it that we got to understand that we don't understand why animals do what they're supposed to do? Why? Because God is a God of nature, and the one who sees God is the one who's going to have understanding. You're not shouting because I'm stepping on somebody's foot right now, because you said, you know what? I've sat back and I've allowed too many people to tell me what's wrong and what not to do. I've been hooked up so much on soap operas, hooked up so much on these judge TV shows, but rather not paying attention to what's happening in the world. I got news for it. You better find out what's happening in the world. You do realize Mitt Romney chose Paul Ryan for his vice presidential candidate, and you better understand what that man does in his financial plan. I know I'm supposed to talk about, but the church ought to talk about educating their people. I'm not telling you who to vote for, who not to vote for, but if you want to make sure you got Medicare and Medicaid, you better understand their policy. If you want to make sure about social programs, you better understand their policy, because guess what? When people mess with social programs, they're messing with God's people, and you need to understand what happens when you mess with God's people. And there's time for God's people not just to stand around the altar and pray, Chris, but it's time for God's people to get out and cast their vote and vote for the right man for the job, and not just vote for the right man, but hold the man accountable. Yeah, I voted you in, but because I vote you in don't mean I'm gonna let you use me or abuse me, because the Bible says the heart of him who has understanding seeks knowledge, and that's what I'm talking about. We need to understand everything from church protocol to the political protocol. The schools are out there, the internet is out there, the books are out there. All we have to do is roll up our sleeves and learn something. But hold on for a second. I got too many kids in the house. We just can't learn it, but we've got to apply it. Isn't that something? You got a whole lot of people got book knowledge, but don't have common sense knowledge. Can I bring it in? I'm gonna take my book knowledge and I'm gonna transfer it to my common sense knowledge, and then I can use application. See, when I use application, now I'll take what I've learned from the Bible, take it from what I've learned in school, and now I can apply it to my life. It bothers me, because have you ever been to the store and you've gone to the store and you've given somebody some money before, yet they're so pressed and dependent upon a computer to tell them the exact change that they're supposed to get. And when that computer messes up, they lose all common sense. Okay, y'all not feeling me. Let me help y'all with this. I know this is not in my sermon. Let me help y'all. I was at the store a few years ago, JP, and somebody was in front of me, rung something up, and the price came to $2.87. He gave the lady a $10 bill. Well, you know, automatically change to $7.13. Well, guess what? As he gave her the $10 bill, she typed in $10. He said, hold on for a second. He said, I'm going to give me my 10 back. I got a 5. He gave it to her. She looked confused. And she said, well, you gave me a 10. She said, no, I want the 10 back. Here's a 5. And she looked confused. Well, you got to give me your 10. I couldn't take it no more. I said, ma'am, all you got to do is give the brother back 213. It'll all round itself out. Stop paying attention to the computer and use your education that you got in school, because you have some intelligence. Don't get so caught up on the computer that you can't even use your own mind. So it says the heart of him who has understanding seeks knowledge, because we want to be like God. So if you want to be like God, why not try to serve God? Try to find out what God's will is for your life. All you got to do is say, God, what's my will? God, how do I find your will? Let me get into the book. Let me open it up and let me start reading and asking questions and talking to God, and not only talking, but hearing from God. But here's the last verse. It says the mouth of fools feed on foolishness. The mouth of fools feed on gossip. Oh my goodness. The mouth of fools always open their mouth without even thinking. Okay, do we know anybody like that? They speak without even thinking. And as soon as they open up their mouth, it's nothing but foolishness. A foolish person can't think for themselves. A foolish person has no vision. A foolish person doesn't know what to say. It's like, whatever you say goes. I don't really know anything. I'm going to take your word for it. Oh, y'all messed up. Let me help you. All my kids, this is what you do when you go back to school. I know I'm going to get in trouble with the parents, but I dare you to do it anyway. Do your research. This is your homework, Jay. When it comes down to Christopher Columbus Day, and they say Christopher Columbus discovered America, I dare you to say, I challenge you on that. How? Because how can a man discover what was already here? Okay, y'all missed that. Okay, now talk to me now. How can a man discover what was already here? The Native Americans were already here. How can he discover when he was already lost? But the problem is we get caught up into a school system that will teach us lies, that will tell us mistruth, and we go around and say, yeah, Christopher Columbus, Columbus discovered America. No, he didn't discover America. Read your book. Open up your mind from American history to the Native American history. You do realize the whites were not here first. It was the Native Americans that were here first. And oh, here's my good part. This is my shout. How can they talk about immigration when they brought us here from Africa to on the, from the plantation? Here they took us, they stole us. And yet they talk about all of our Latino brothers and sisters are illegal. Now wait a minute. According to my history book, didn't they come over here illegally? Didn't they come over here with violence and destruction? And yet they get upset saying this is their country. This is what? Our country. So we got to understand, read the history. See, the fool, the what? The mouth of fools feed on foolishness. See, what happens as long as we don't connect the dots, we will always believe everybody else. Okay, y'all missed it. Let me up. Pastor Jeremiah Wright, who talked about everything during Pat President Barack Obama's campaign. Yes, Fox News, which is Fox Lynching, if you really want to call it. They can't stand people of color. And they showed Jeremiah Wright saying, goddamn America. But they did not show the whole sermon whereby he was talking about what America was doing to all these other countries. They show you a snippet to prove their point. But if you watch the whole story, JP, all 30 minutes of the sermon, you will understand nothing wrong with the man said. They just took one part of it. But guess what? When you have a heart of understanding, you can say, I just don't want that little piece. Give me the beginning and give me the end, because God gave me the intellect to draw the conclusion and to draw the reference. Y'all missed it. Knowledge is fruitful. It will help you gain. It will help you blow up, as long as you use knowledge to do what God has called you to do. Well, you're not good, but let me go ahead and give you two and we out of here. The first thing that the text lets us know why knowledge is fruitful is that knowledge will make you better. Y'all like that? See, knowledge will make you better. See, it's so much better when you're hanging around someone who's intelligent. Because according to sports, all my sports fans, you do realize when you play sports and you play somebody better, it only makes you better. Thank you, Daniel. Work for you on that. But see, when you play somebody better, it just makes you better. But when you're not smart and you hang around people who are not as smart as you, what happens? You're not good. It's not fruitful because you're not hanging around someone as good. So knowledge will make you fruitful, and that it will make you better. If you want a better job, I dare you to go back to school. If you want to learn how to do some computer work, I dare you to open up a book. If you whatever you want to do, I dare you to seek knowledge, because guess what? Knowledge will make you fruitful. Isn't that something? Why we got all these people who are unemployed going back to school, Don? They going back to school to find another career. The only way they can do it is say, wait a minute. I used to be a mechanic, but now I'm going to school to be a business person, because I'm realizing that business is the way to go. Y'all not feeling me like I need you to. If you really want to have knowledge of being fruitful, go back to school and learn how to speak Spanish. I'm going to tell you right now, if you speak Spanish, you'll not only be on the same footing, but you'll have double the anointing. Why? Because not only will you speak English well, but you can speak Spanish proficient. So now on your application, you can say, not only am I fluent in English, not only am I fluent in Spanish, but I'm also educated. That's not just being fruitful, because we're thinking outside the box. And we think outside the box, that means God opens up opportunities. Well, you may not want to work for somebody, but guess what? You may want to have your business. And you can say, you know what? Not only can I speak English, proper English, but I can also go into the Latino neighborhood and conduct business, because now I'm bilingual. Okay, y'all missed that. See, don't you guys see, when you're bilingual, that adds $10,000 to $20,000 on your salary. And when you add $10,000 to $20,000, isn't that something? Because see, they on job application said bilingual. Add Spanish, preferred, but not required. That's why you gotta have more than just one language. That's why knowledge is fruitful. We're coming in a day, my friend, whereby we just can't be in the church 24/7. We've got to open up the door and say, yeah, I'm creating my own opportunity. Why? Because the one who has not seeks understanding. I'm trying to make way out of no way. So God has given us all the gifts. But here's my last shout, and this is real good, right? Knowledge is truth. Okay, y'all look at me kind of like, knowledge is truth. Knowledge tells you good from bad. Isn't that what King Solomon did? King Solomon, when he was preaching and learning from the Lord, the Lord came to Solomon one night in a dream and said, Solomon, what do you want? Solomon said, look here, Lord, I got all these people here. I'm the king. I really don't know what to do. So Lord, won't you give me a discerning heart to know how to lead these people? And in the process, God, teach me how to do right from wrong. See, and God said, you know what, Solomon, because you asked for the right thing, I'm going to give you that, but I'm also going to give you what you didn't ask for. I'm not only going to give you wisdom, but I'm also going to give you riches. Y'all missed that. Because you asked for wisdom, I'm going to not only give help you pen in Proverbs, but also I'm going to give you riches. Come on, talk to me, Solomon. How is it you can build a temple? How by your hands, how is it that you can negotiate all the people around you to work for you, to build the great temple of God and to build a palace for yourself? Because Solomon asked for wisdom. Well, you're not with me. Let me help you. JP, I don't want to go there with people, but I know I got some people that used to walk that watch Maury Povich in here. And you do Maury Povich. Maury Povich always has some crazy people on it, you know, whose baby daddy is this 1, 2, 3, or 4. And it really bothers me because I hate when somebody says, who's my baby daddy? Because that's so ghetto and so foul. Can you just say, who's the father of my child? But that's another story for another time. But he said, let's go ahead and take the DNA test, because the DNA test will prove whether or not you are this child's father. And we all see the episodes. Yeah, I watch when I get bored and I'm going to get stupid every now and again. It says, you are not the father, or you are the father. Well, you know what? It dawned on me for a second, because you know what? We already got a better DNA than our family's DNA. We got God's DNA. And I realized you got God's DNA. That DNA means divine natural attributes. See, y'all missed your shout on that. See, that's why knowledge is true, because when God stamps us with this spirit, he gives us a DNA. And that DNA means I'm already knowledgeable. Yeah. And DNA means when I walk with God, I'm going to be fruitful. When I'm hooked up with God, that means I only want the best, and I can't settle for the less. When I'm hooked up with God, everything I do must be in the spirit of excellence. When I have God's DNA, that means I want to have knowledge.
Yes.
That means I got to always be learning. That means I got to always be free. That means I got to always have my mind active, because a mind that's not active is already dead. And I don't believe anybody here wants to be dead. We all want to be alive in God, because God has given us a mind.
Yes.
To do so. What's it? Wait, I'm about to close. Didn't they say, what's the thing? Do not need to go say, a mind is a terrible thing to waste.
Yes.
And isn't it a shame we got a lot of people out here wasting their mind?
Yes.
So as you go back to school tomorrow, I implore you, go ahead and be the nerd. Nothing wrong with getting A's. Nothing wrong with getting A's. Because A means, you know what, you're first class.
Yes.
And when someone tells you don't get an A, say, I'm sorry, I can't go down to your level, because I'm going somewhere.
Yes.
Look at President Barack Obama. Look how smart that brother is. Yes. Look at all the people who are, look how smart they are. See, when you choose to have knowledge, it will open up some doors.
Yes,
for you.
It will.
It will open up colleges for you. It will open up job opportunities. It will open up internships. So do me a favor. Whoever's trying to tell you be dumb, let them be dumb by yourself. Don't join that party. Go ahead and be smart. Get all the A's. Don't settle for B. Don't settle for C. Why don't you go ahead and shoot for A plus? And I promise you, if you get A's, I'm promising you, if you get A's and keep your hand in God's hand, God will open up the door for you. Yeah, you'll have some ups and some downs, but I guarantee you, if you do good in school, God will open up doors for you that other people can't even get into. And oh, that's my young, but let me get to my older folks. If we open up our minds and be all that God has called us to be, to start connecting now, we will be in a better position than we are today. If you're sick and tired of being sick and tired, open up a book, go back to school, expand your knowledge, and when you expand your knowledge, you will become fruitful. Yeah.